is Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
The views and opinions of the hosts and guests are their own and do not necessarily reflect the position of the management and staff of Guardian Network.
The aftermath of every social revolution brings about change. Cultural norms and landmarks shift as our minds and hearts expand beyond the familiar. To everything, there is a season and a time to every purpose in the land of the living. This is our time to renew, revive, and restore the hope lost to the busyness of life. This is our time to dig again and rebuild from the storms of our past on a solid footing that holds. Welcome to The Foundation.
The Foundation.
The Foundation with Hearts Grant is brought to you by Alive, Burger King, Commonwealth Bank, the Deposit Insurance Corporation, Grand Bahama News, Popeyes, and Ron's Electric Motors.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. 96.9 FM Radio, Howard Grant in your company. The Foundation on this absolutely gorgeous Monday afternoon, live and in full effect. It is an absolutely beautiful day. Monday, 23rd, here in the land of the living. I'm so happy to be with you guys here. It is day Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday. Day 5. Locked up. I just got to be dramatic as possible.
Good
locked up
afternoon.
Well, it's not really locked up, right? It's Howard Grant is in Hong Kong. And from the last time we had a conversation on Friday, we're still here. The Consulate General, the High Commissioner from Beijing, all those persons, High Commissioner rather from London, and the Consulate General here in Beijing has been doing their absolute best to kind of get me out. Hopefully, by the time that you hear this, I will be on a plane back to Las Bahamas. Come on, man, the shallow waters. I'm so happy to be with you guys today. It's a beautiful day. I'm grateful for it. Guys, I want you to pick up your newspaper. Make sure you pick up your Guardian newspaper. Guardian newspaper got all the stuff in there. I'm sure they're going to be talking about politics. I don't see it. I can't see it. Don't fight me. I'm sure they're going to be talking about politics. I'm sure they're going to be talking about what's going to be happening on the ground. Over the weekend, we saw a great deal of things happen. I was all the way over here in Hong Kong, and I can see what's going on Farrington Road. The thing is absolutely bananas. I mean, Brave got to go. You need to stop it in Jesus' name. Y'all just do too much. I don't know this to be the PLP that I know. Y'all normally go inside the building and do your thing. But today, I suppose the indecency spilled out. It's a beautiful day, guys. I want you to be able to, like I said, make sure you pick up your Guardian newspaper. Check that out. And also, I want to be able to thank the persons that are committed to being able to assist us on this trip all the way over to China, right? Grammy said, your foot too short. I stopped short, right? I come right here to Hong Kong when I was getting ready to go to Guangzhou over the lake to the Canton Trade Fair, where it stopped right here. Guys, listen to the show on Friday. You'll hear the entire thing, how the thing laid out. But we're still here in Hong Kong, and I want to thank the persons that committed to being able to assist us and doing all that they've done. That's Bahama Bus and Truck. Bahama Bus and Truck, my good friend Ben Aubrey, has always been committed to being able to assist us on all various platforms. So I want to thank him. Make sure you go down there and check out Bahama Bus and Truck. You can be able to pick them up on Facebook. They have a website. You can pick them up. Google them, Bahamas Bus and Truck. They get the absolute best vehicles in the game. I know that they're heavy on Jeeps, doing all manner of stuff. Go down there. Tell Ben Aubrey that Howard Grant sent you down here and you want a little slack thing. I mean, it's time, man. I think it's transitioning time. A lot of persons are actually starting to move about and make those things happen in terms of being able to move. I see a lot of people traveling and doing some stuff like that. I'm excited about that. I'm excited about the fact that we're actually moving now. I'm really grateful for the opportunity. So if you're one of those persons who want to make another step in your life and you want to do something significant in terms of being able to move forward, go down there to Bahamas Bus and Truck to my good friend, Ben Aubrey. And I say good friend, I mean, listen to me. I can't even tell you how far me and Ben go back from 2012. Let's just be very clear. Ben Aubrey, go down there. Let him, like I said, let him know that Howard Grant sent you. And I'm grateful for his support and everything that he does for us. Make sure you also go and check out my good friends over at Mallaby Butler & Sons. They are located north, right? When you're headed north on Blue Hill Road, just west of Wesley Methodist Church right there on the right hand side, on the eastern side. You're going to be able to see Milo B. Butler and Sons. You go down there and check it out, man. They got great protein packages. When I say protein packages, you know, you got the chicken, your turkey, your pork chop, all those great things to be able to feed your church children's sustenance. You can't keep shoving noodles down their throat and sausages. Come on, let's just be very clear about the thing. Get yourself some great packages and tap into some of that chef teach you how to be able to put those things together. Do some stewed turkey, them big legs. Let the children see. The children of the future, you got to feed them. My God, or they might make it. Give them something hot and heavy, something good to eat. Go down there to Milo B. Butler and Sons and be able to get those things. Those, like I said, those protein packages. You have a great deal of things available, and I want you guys to be able to support them. Let them know, like I said, that Howard Grant sent you from the foundation. He'd be more than happy to assist you. Forgive me now. You know, you're going to hear one or two things in the background. Like, you know that we're still in the airport, so we're kind of doing everything that we can do. And it's just crazy. It feels like so many cars are coming now since we're here, right? But we're in Hong Kong, and I want to thank you guys for being able to do that. And make sure you go down there and check out AFS Insurance Agents and Brokers also. That's my very good friend, Ethric Bro, out there on South. He's south, headed south on Blue Hill Road, just east of the Golden Gate Shopping Center. He'd be more than happy to assist you with those things. And get yourself your insurance, man. We are creeping up to the end of the month again. What today is the 23rd? We're creeping up to the end of the month again. And I don't know where you are as it relates to being able to get your stuff together, but we need you to get that together. Please go down there, check my guy out, get everything laid out and taken care of. Get your car insured and stop riding dirty. Okay? Be decent in the year of our Jubilee. Let Ethric Bo and his beautiful wife know that I have sent you guys down there and that you're looking for that package, that little slack package, the foundation package, that you can be able to get your car insured and get everything done, especially if you just bought a car from Bahamas Bus and Truck. Go down there, get it insured with my guy, AFS Insurance, and we can be able to make these things happen. And last but definitely, absolutely not least, I want to tell you about a church that has been progressive in its thinking in every aspect. I want to do that. I have been in tune, I mean, intimately trying to be able to find out more and more information about it. And the opportunities that it has given us to be able to, my wife and I, to kind of rekindle a lot of our relationships. You guys, you know that in November, in a month, exactly in a month, I'll be celebrating my 20th anniversary. And there is a wonderful series happening right now over at Bahamas Harvest Church with none other than Pastor Mario Moxie. Pastor Mario and Erica Moxie, they are there and being able to put this package, to put this message series together. It's called Let's Stay Together. It's really directed towards married couples, but not necessarily those persons who's married right now, but those persons who want to kind of rekindle, rejuvenate, revive their relationship. Those persons who are looking to get married is sort of a course to let you know that this is the path that you should be able to take. For those persons who've kind of fell into certain spaces and places, it's very important that you understand that there's renewal, revival, restoration available for you. Go down there and check it out on the church's website. It's bahamaharvest.com. Is it bahamaharvest.com? Check them out on Facebook, Bahama Harvest. You can be able to see the information. They get an app there. Download the app, Bahama Harvest Church app. All the information's in there. Look at the series. The series is absolutely phenomenal. It is a phenomenal series. And I do not say that lightly. I mean, it has placed my wife and I. She called me all the way down here. Oh, church was good today. She had an opportunity to go to church yesterday. Oh, church was good. And then she sent me the sermon notes. So I'm reading the entire sermon notes, sleeping on these people's bench. It is bananas. But you know, you got to keep yourself encouraged and keep your spirit encouraged as you continue to be able to move forward and do those things. Listen, man, I'm always optimistic. I always tell you that if you ain't dead, my grandmother tells me that if you ain't past nothing until you're dead. And though we have great aspirations to make significant moves, right? Sometimes that does not necessarily the move for us. And that's why I say, I think I find myself in that position now. You understand? And who knows? You know, I get mad spiritual sometimes. Who knows what's beyond that kind of a restricted point for me? I'm grateful for preservation. Talk to me. How I talking? Praise God. I'm grateful for preservation. I'm grateful and I'm sensitive to the fact that I make no moves without first understanding that this is the will that I've been called to, moving in the purpose that I've been called to, and in alignment to know that I'm doing what I'm called to do in the season that is mine. I just don't want to get preachy with you, but I got to let you know that sometimes you got to be optimistic. As long as we have health and strength and breath in our bodies, I think it's very important that we continue to be able to be prayerful, grateful, and move with that sort of gratitude in our spirits. I want to be able to say, whilst we're talking about the land of the living, I want to be able to give condolences to Dr. Gomez, the family of Dr. Gomez, who's actually passed away. You know, just seeing this information comes through and start to talk about it and talk about those lives that have been lost. You know, it's an amazing thing. Former Member of Parliament for the Northern Andros and Berry Islands, Minister of Health, Dr. Perry Gomez, has passed away at his home. This is some information that actually came through, I think, Saturday, right? And I want to say this. I think we look at ourselves and we continue to be able to recognize our mortality and how it continues to be able to fleet. And the vapor that is life is more and more pronounced every day. These are prominent men and women in our society that are just passing away. They've yielded and gave their service to the country, and the fathers called them home, and these guys are gone. I mean, it's an amazing thing. So I continue to be able to pray for the family of Dr. Perry Gomez. I know Damien Gomez is going through some stuff, and the other Gomez's. I know you guys are going through a great deal of things. You have really given some gems to the country. And we just pray that the Father continues to watch over you, keep you safe from harm, snares, danger, sudden death, and destruction, strengthen you and lift you up in your time of bereavement moving forward. I want to thank you for that. I want to thank you for those things, because now that we're talking about physical death, there is also a sense of political death in the air. Can I say that? It is wild. I think it's too much. But I feel like the political grim reaper is being able to separate the chaff from the wheat. Man, how I preach it? I getting too heavy? It's too much? I am grateful for the opportunity to be able to be joined with my good, decent friend all the way from Nassau, Bahamas. Because, you know, I tell you, in Hong Kong, all the way from Nassau, Bahamas, none other than my very good friend, Garth Roseboro. Garth, you are here with us today, my brother. I thank you for taking the time to have this kind of a good conversation with me. Say good afternoon to the people out there.
Well, Howard Grant, it's always good to be with you. Good to be with the people of the Commonwealth of the Bahamas and to the listeners that are international, Hong Kong and China included, abroad. It's good to be here, even though you've now tasted what it means to be like Joseph, incarcerated. We hope that once you are released by Pharaoh, that you will then ascend to the throne.
Listen, you're killing me. Listen to me. Listen, I locked up. I just want to be as decent as possible when we do that, my brother. I'm out here, but I'm grateful. How you been, my brother? Talk to me.
Well, you know, maybe it took an experience such as this for you to run independent in the by-election, eh?
Jesus God Almighty. You know how much calls I've gotten over the past 4 days? Listen to me. As I continue to be able to stew, right? I took like a cold shower. I took like a few cold showers, washing all my clothes and whatnot, because I only had a little carry-on with my little underwear and my singlet and things like that in there. But I had my equipment. So I got my equipment with me. That's why I'm able to do the show. But I push everything else through in my big bag, right? So I had to wash up and everything like that. And in the midst of me trying to figure out, Lord, what is this? I'm getting calls from Grand Mahama, calls from Nassau. I get Layvon Miller, C.A. Nuri, everyone on Facebook bullying me, telling me I'm the great white hope for West Grand Mahama. You all need to stop it and know that I'm out here trying to fight for my life like King Kong in Hong Kong. You all need to stop it. It's a lot that we're out here doing. But a lot of persons are saying these things in terms of the independence and going down to West Grand Mahama. Let's talk about that today, my brother. What do you see? Because you're on the ground. I'm not on the ground. What are you hearing? I'm literally in the air. I could see mountains outside, but I can't put my foot on the ground. What are you hearing?
I was an active participant in the by-election with Dr. Dwayne Sands and Ryan Pinder. And that was for the Elizabeth constituency. I do not recall the candidates on the FNM nomination battle. But if I can remember correctly, on the PLP side, there was one Mr. Craig Butler. There was Ryan Pinder.
This is Bamboo Town? Oh, no. When this is Elizabeth.
This was Elizabeth. I remember we were fighting for Elizabeth. I think Alex Stoll's name went in there somewhere. And then I remember Dwayne Hanna, who's now deceased. You know, God rest his soul. He was a good man. And Dwayne Hanna was thought to be the one. And I think he passed some two weeks or so after seeking the bid. But I never recalled such mayhem.
I want to talk
a call
about
for
this.
Resignation by a leader.
I want to talk about this. You know I will get into
I've
this.
I've never heard of any disturbance in the Free National Movement camp.
Hold on.
What I do recall is that the Right Honorable Hubert Alexander Ingram was at the helm of the FNM ship.
Hold on.
And Honorable Perry Glasson Christie was at the top of the PLP. And I recall I was a speaker, actually. You wouldn't believe this. I was the first speaker at the rally for the PLP rally. And I was introduced, by the way, to the platform by Obadiah Wilchkum.
I think I remember you telling me this story. I think I do remember you telling me this story. Now, listen, before you go any further, I think I'm up for my first commercial break. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to thank you so much for tuning in. We're going to get deep into politics today. I know that you was waiting to hear none other than Fred Mitchell. We're going to be able to pull that together for you, absolutely. It's just over the past few days, it's been a little rough. Don't fight me. We're going to make this thing happen. He's committed to doing that. He's helping me in other ways, though, definitely, as the Minister of Foreign Affairs got his persons kind of enacted to get me out of here locked up in Hong Kong. I'm right here doing my thing, ladies and gentlemen. Let me take this quick commercial break and be right back after this.
At Popeyes, get the chicken sandwich you love, but make it blackened. Marinated in Popeyes blackened seasoning, that is. Our new juicy filet is fried to perfection without the breading, served on a toasted brioche bun. Try it today as a combo or a la carte. Don't forget to choose your level of spice today at any one of our three locations.
Love that chicken from Popeyes.
Guardian Radio and the Foundation are on the move.
Bahamas, this one's for you.
SBT. Small Business Thursdays. Every Thursday, the Foundation with Howard Grant will highlight small businesses throughout the country, far and wide. Your products, services, prices, and personality. We want to hear it all. Get your 30 or 60 second advertisement heard on air at a fraction of the cost. We here at the Foundation understand the times and don't want you to be left behind. With Guardian Radio, you reach your specific demographic and it is unmatched.
We reach thousands daily.
Get your products off the shelf and your services in their hearts. Small Business Thursdays with the Foundation, only on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. For more information, call 302-2300 or the Help Me Howard line at 827-0111. SBT. Small Business Thursdays. Get your business moving today.
It's the Battle of the Bras, sponsored by Canoe, and you decide who wins. October is Breast Cancer Awareness Month, so strap on your gloves and join the fight. It's easy. Just download the Canoe app, vote for Mammogram Access Program, the Grand Bahama Cancer Society, or Sister Sister, or go to the Battle of the Bra event page on Facebook and vote. Each vote is just $5. Polls open on October 2nd and close on October 26th. Vote as many times as you want. You can even vote for all three. It's the Battle of the Bra. The winner will be announced on Friday, October 27th at the Pink Lotus Affair at Blair House.
This is my fight song. Take back my life song. Prove I'm alright song.
And we are back, ladies and gentlemen. 96.9 FM Radio. Howard Grant in your company. The Foundation locked up. All the way in Hong Kong, doing our thing, ladies and gentlemen. It's a beautiful thing to be here in your company today. Make sure you call someone. Let them know that we're here live and in full effect, and we're going to be talking politics today. I'm joined by none other than my very good friend, Garth Roseborough. He started trying to talk about the by-election that happened in Elizabeth and how he remembered the strategic players associated with the by-election, but not necessarily seeing sort of the unraveling, the turmoil, the mayhem that exists in this kind of a space and time. Garth, tell people about it. Talk to me about it.
You know, I recall being the was the deputy chair of what they call the caucus of the PLP at that time, who strategized for that particular by-election. And there were very noted young people that just gathered together 7 days a week until 4 a.m. in the morning, every morning on Step Street at one Mr. Fred Ramming's house. And the end result of it, long story short, is that of cohesiveness, that of aggressiveness, and the unity of replacing Malcolm Attlee as the resigning member of parliament and instating Ryan Pinder in the PLP seemed seamless. It was just an energy, a synergy, a togetherness that was unmatched by the FNM. The volunteerism was very high. There wasn't a big exchange of monies in terms of those who were volunteering their services. But of course, a lot of money is always spent on the ground. In this particular election, it is now for the PLP to once again prove, can they now repeat the same performance? The difference is, in the Elizabeth by-election, they were in the opposition. Now they are the government and all eyes are on the PLP. And the PLP, in our eyes, seems to be disintegrating only because of favoritism towards a Shane Gibson. And then people are asking the question, who is this Kingsley Smith? Now, Grandmom is saying, Kingsley Smith is our friend. Shane Gibson needs to retire. The people who know Shane Gibson from New Providence are saying, you must be don't know who Shane Gibson is. Look at his resume. And so now what we have in the Progressive Liberal Party is a battle between a popular Shane Gibson and not Kingsley Smith, but a battle with Shane Gibson and Fred Mitchell. And some way, somehow, you're the leader, the Prime Minister of the Commonwealth of the Bahamas, Philip Rafe Davis, is got caught in the middle. And as quick as he entered on a Friday, was as quick as he left on a Friday night.
Now, I want to talk with this. Let's get it like this. There is no way that you could speak about the leadership of the Progressive Liberal Party without understanding that there is a trifecta that exists. And though that there is a silent sea, the silent sea is Chester Cooper. Though there is a silent sea, the pronounced B, which is Brave Davis, Philip Brave Davis, PB, and the pronounced and yes. ever so buoyant Fred Mitchell, F, that kind of an F sharp, whilst they speak, he never speaks and can never speak constitutionally and otherwise. And even for the tradition that exists within our culture, he could never speak solely on his own two. He is a proverbial stool, and the stool sits on three prongs, one, two, three. You understand? And so when you see Fred Mitchell take a strong course and position, you have to know that that's associated with the thinking existing in the leadership trifecta. Come on, man, talk to me. How are we talking? Am I making sense?
Following.
Okay, you're there with me.
The idea here, though, and I like what you said about the Deputy Prime Minister, Chester Cooper, the Deputy Leader, being somewhat silent. It's almost as if he's playing a chess game, and he's now sitting as the rook on the chessboard while Fred Mitchell is playing the queen. Now, we're playing for the checkmate, and I want you to understand that Fred has always had leadership ability, but he's also had leadership ambition. As we look at Glenys Hannah Martin, who we say as a female, very strong, also had that same ability. And then we look at Obadiah Wilshcombe, the late Obadiah Wilshcombe, who also had leadership ambition. But we could never overlook the fact that Shane Gibson said, you know what? I'm also leadership material. And if I could only get back in,
no,
then the only thing that stands in my way would be a Chester Cooper for the future.
Anytime.
And this is why we can see a very aggressive Shane Gibson. And what baffled me, because I kind of like him as a person. I'm not going to talk about his scandalous background that you all feel he should be locked up. I'm not talking about that. I know as a person, he's very personable. He has a magnetism about himself. And as we looked at Shane Gibson walking out of Gambier House on Farringdon Road, I have never seen a Shane Gibson, D. Shane Gibson, look so defeated and so forlorn. I saw that night on video.
I want to be able to do a couple things here. I got to be able to debunk some things that you put in the front there. Because I don't think introspection. And guys, this is why I love this. And this is why I choose to do this from the floor in Hong Kong. Because I see some things a little different. Every time I start to think about leadership, I remember the one voice that pops up in my head and continues to be able to, almost like Casper running to and fro in my mind, is Hubert Ingraham's voice. And Hubert Ingraham, to a young, pliable Howard Grant, said some stuff that never left me. And I don't know if it ever will. And when he said that, you know, people tell you could do this, you know. You don't tell yourself you could do these things. People tell you could do this. I always think of that and attach that to the traditional concept of politics in our country. Let me shoot straight and tell you what I mean. Introspection has not placed Shane Gibson in this position. The very first person that we heard advocate for Shane Gibson and the necessity and whether or not he should even be given an opportunity to step in West Grand Bahama was a silver fox. And I mean that with the greatest degree of respect. And who am I talking about? Who am I talking about? I'm talking about none other than former Prime Minister Perry Gladstone Christie, that was an advocate, has perpetually and always relentlessly been an advocate for his decent friend, Shane Gibson. Come on, talk to me. How am I talking? Am I making sense? His advocacy... His advocacy for Shane Gibson and the players on the ground simultaneously makes me to understand, despite the fact that the Progressive Liberal Party has always been a machine viewed as being able to move with this kind of a steady kinetic motion of one leader, there is a fraction in the PLP. Talk to me. And there is another PLP that seeks to rise to the fore. Talk to me about it.
Yes, because you see, remember now, this is the same friend of mine, Perry Gladstone Christie, though, who has always been accused of not being able to make a decision. Is this not the same? But all of a sudden, in this by-election, he can make a decision pro-Shane Gibson. And so if people have looked upon you in the past as one not being able to make a firm and strong decision, how much value do they now have in your recommendation? You see, this is how our history comes to haunt us in the present and can definitely make our future. When I look at D. Shane Gibson, I will say this to you, though. I saw an opportunity, a great opportunity that this all afforded D. Shane Gibson.
But you and I had this conversation.
I told you this.
Y'all don't listen to me. I told you this. I say if it happened, I will be surprised. But I knew that desperation in West Grand Bahama could cause some persons, even with the allure, the idea of getting some money. Talk to me. Let's be very clear about this. Even with the allure of getting money, if it happens, it only could speak to the brokenness of West Grand Bahama. And guess what? It did not happen. Now, there are some loud players. There are some persons who are extremely vocal. That's a tradition of politics in this country. That is that kind of a scream and see if we can be able to get it, right? That's the two types of politics, right? So there's the honey and the vinegar. This was the vinegar that we saw the other evening in the front of the PLP headquarters on Farrington Road. This was vinegar. It was a handful. But there is a decision that has been made in West Grand Bahama. There is a decision that has been made within the caucus of the PLP that says Shane is not the guy to go forward. Now, I believe the trifecta, the leadership, the silent C, the sharp F, and the pronounced PB has made a decision that Shane Gibson entering the fold would cause a problem leading towards 2026. Talk to me about it.
Let me put this to you, Howard Grant. And I know we have much to talk about in this by-election. This is not a one-day story that we can even begin to conversate on. D. Shane Gibson now, if he retains his status in the Progressive Liberal Party as a member in good and regular standing, this would also mean that he will also be able to vie in the upcoming, what are they having again now?
Convention. The convention.
Convention.
Yes, convention.
Convention.
Yes, convention.
In the convention, Deshaun Gibson can now vie for chairmanship and go after the very one who was his adversary,
listen,
Fred Mitchell, and say, I want your job.
Listen,
now.
Listen.
And the question is, even though the party may not have been able to give him the nomination in West Grand Mahomet and Bimini, the question before the public now is, can a Deshaun Gibson win in a convention for the position of chairmanship over a Fred Mitchell?
No. And there's no two ways for me to be able to kind of shave it and make it sound funky fresh for you and make it sound nice and politically palatable and all these things that there is a very clear, precise no, emboldened around with brackets in it. That has to be able to have a bigger italics than everybody else. No, there is no way that Shane Gibson could win at a leadership convention to be a chairman for the Progressive Liberal Party. Let me tell you why. Let me explain to you. In political organizations, they vote in blocks. This happens in the FNM. And you know I know this, okay? They vote in blocks. The leadership identifies who he or she desires on their ticket. There's a ticket that goes forward, okay? So the ticket has, let's call it the A-team, okay? The A-team, the dream team. The ticket has leadership. He's already the current leader. Right? He's proposed or purported or identified as the leader of the organization. The leadership team, which is the deputy and the chairman, that's a part of the ticket. And the sub-persons or the subcommittee on that ticket, all are persons who will be supported in getting there. Because why? If the leaders say, these are the people that I want to be on the ticket to move towards this particular thing, the caucus, which was the MCMs and the Free National Movement, and which is also going to be the stalwart council members in the PRP, the caucus has a responsibility and obligation to ensure that they do not stifle the leader's ability to be able to get some things done for the organization. Shane Gibson, if he's not a part of that proverbial ticket, cannot get in there. They're going to have to be able to have another ticket, a ticket that is dedicated, that has its own leader, that has its deputy, that has its chairman, if you're saying Shane Gibson is going to be the chairman, and that has a body of people that could be able to support the supporting cast members to get this objective out. If Shane Gibson is solely looking to become the chairman, that could never happen. That could never happen. Not solely, not independently. He has to run on a ticket. And the question is whether or not there is the kind of contention in the PLP right now that will create a second force within the organization to run concurrent towards the next convention. And in my view, I don't think it is. Talk to me about it. But before we do that, let me take this quick commercial break and be right back after this.
We've been with you from the very start, leading the way and providing you with the best in primetime sporting experiences. From one goal to the next, you can count on us for full access to the best sports channels at home or on the go. Make Rev your only choice. Visit rev.bs. Every match, every game, every moment. Rev, your home for sports.
America completely run out of it.
At Ron's Electric Motors, they repair and rewind all major brands of electric motors, including water pumps, generators, and generators back end, welding machines, electric lifts, air compressors, battery chargers, and more. They're equipped to handle up to 850 kilowatts and rewind up to 450 horsepower motors. They're conveniently located on the corner of Wolf and Clarence Roads and are open weekdays 8 a.m. to 5 p.m., Saturdays till noon. They offer 24 hours emergency assistance. You can reach them 242-356-0249.
Let me ask you a few questions. What's your name?
Pam.
Favorite food?
Steak.
Beer or wine?
Wine.
Is your money safe?
It's under my bed, I guess so.
Are you serious?
Yeah, why?
Unless your money is in a bank or credit union that's a member of the Deposit Insurance Corporation, there's no guarantee it's safe.
Yeah, but what if something happens to the bank?
Your Bahamian dollar deposits are insured up to $50,000, so you'd still be ahead. Plus, your mattress might catch fire. Then what?
Man, those banks and credit unions are looking good right about now.
Visit the DIC's website at www.dic.bs. Protection for your money, guaranteed with DIC.
Loss of family members is very isolating, and people who have experienced loss appreciate when others have shared their grief. If you can't be there in person, go to the Nassau Guardian's website online at thenassauguardian.com and visit our obituary link. The Nassau Guardian's interactive obituary link allows you to read the funeral announcement express condolences, or place photos on the online guest book for one full year. Losing a loved one is painful, but that pain isn't the worst thing to happen. Friends, loved ones, colleagues, and neighbors who ignore the loss compound the pain. Should the bereaved family wish to place the obituary and photos on our obituary site, just contact the Guardian's Funeral Industry Partners or the Nassau Guardian. Remember, there isn't one magic right thing to say to someone experiencing loss that will make the loss less painful or easier to bear. The Nassau Guardian's obituary link, available online at thenassauguardian.com.
Are you interested in the Bahamian economy? How about tips to improve your financial literacy? Tune into Guardian Radio's newest financial podcast series, C-File Talks. The podcast will provide listeners with their weekly dose of economic issues and solutions and the keys to financial freedom. C-File Talks will be hosted by an array of finance experts here to give honest and beneficial advice. You won't want to miss the C-File Talks podcast series, Monday evenings from 6:30 to 7 p.m. here on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM.
Hi Bahamas, it's Dr. Denothra Archer Cartwright from the Doctors Inn on Guardian Radio 96.9. Join me every Tuesday evening at 6:30 p.m. for all things health, wellness, and things that pertain to the Bahamian Society. Tune in at 6:30 p.m. Guardian 96.9, the Doctors Inn with me, Dr. Denothra Archer Cartwright.
Hi, this is Maddie Boom, your host of Blind Canvas, the home of visual art and culture in the Bahamas. Tune in to 96.9 Guardian Talk Radio on Wednesday at 6:30 p.m.
There comes a time when the game tolerates no spectators, only players. There comes a time when we must recognize that our individual aspirations shape our collective destiny. There comes a time when getting in the game, despite the risks, despite the challenges, regardless of the cost, is simply the right thing to do. There comes a time when we must find our hearts, find our soul, and pursue our purpose for the greater good of all, for country, for humanity. There comes a time when we must manifest our true greatness. Yes, there comes a time, and that time is now. So let's get down to the essentials. The Essentials, serious radio for serious people committed to advancing the national conversation.
The Essentials with Hubert Edwards, Thursday nights live at 6:30 p.m. to 8 p.m. on Guardian Radio 96.9.
This is your host, Valentino Brand, inside the inner city. Join us as we continue to tell our stories, challenges, talk about the history, and share our hopes and dreams. Tune into Inside the Inner City on Fridays at 6:30 p.m. on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. And remember, the place in which I fit will not exist until I make it.
Introducing the Sunday Scotch Society. We invite you to tune in to wide-ranging and insight-filled conversation, fortified by delectable, sumptuous scotches, plus the occasional cigar. We dive deep into little explored realms where we bring you captivating stories, engaging interviews, and discussions that will challenge your perceptions. The world is changing at breakneck speeds, and we're all racing to keep up. Against a backdrop of nearly constant upheaval, we welcome you to the Sunday Scotch Society. Whether it's the crucial issue of the day or a deep dive down a rabbit hole, we're joined by fascinating guests who each bring unique, thought-provoking perspectives to the table. Every Sunday afternoon on Guardian Talk Radio 96.9 FM, join me, K. Quincy Parker, and my co-host, Matthew Kelly, for a stiff drink and a great conversation on the Sunday Scotch Society.
Sundays live on Guardian Talk Radio 96.9 is the time to listen to your favorite talk show, Let's Talk Together in English, hosted by me, Lady T. Are you ready for Anupale Asam? Let's Talk Together in English. It's a 1 hour of news and current affairs, information for the Haitian community living in the Bahamas. Sponsored by Fort Terrace Diagnostic Center. Need to know more about health matters, immigration, support for young learners at home, banking, as well as current affairs concerns that affect the Haitian community. Tune in at 6 p.m. every Sundays for Let's Talk Together in English. Anupale Asam. hosted by me, Lady T, sponsored by Fort Terrace Diagnostic Center, live on Guardian Talk Radio 96.9. Mesami, mesami, mesanu tap chachea, konya, mapote la kaino, avec anou pale ensemble, yo emission ki la pou atake tout sujet ki concerne communauté haïtienne kap vive nan nasyon Bahamas. Tankou, immigration, genio, coronavirus, sak pi important, santé nou. Sponsor a Fort Terrace Diagnostic Center, avec animatrice communauté a Lady T, chaque dimanche à 6h du soir, seul nan Guardian Talk Radio 96.9 FM. Communauté moyen, est-ce que nous parlons?
Voices of the Diaspora. Join us every Sunday from 7 p.m. to 8 p.m., where we provide pertinent information for those who are living in the diaspora in English and in Creole. Voices of the Diaspora. Chaque dimanche, 7h pour 8h p.m. Voix diaspora, côté nous baou bonjour information qui nécessaire pour connaître ce qui passe pour devoir vivre là, dans Bahamas, comme diaspora. Voices of the Diaspora.
Join me, Landlord, along with Mike D, for the entertaining and ministering program, Caribbean and Urban American Gospel Hits.
It's the great hits from the Caribbean and the great hits from all across urban America.
You will hear great music and more, including interviews with popular artists from America.
Hi, this is Richard Smallwood. Listen, I love Carr Salad, Landlord. It's one of my favorite thing, Carr Fritters.
Hi, this is Carvin Winans of Three Winans Brothers.
Hey guys, this is Casey J.
Hey, what's up, everybody? It's your boy, Jonathan McReynolds.
Hello, everybody. I'm Pastor Shirley Caesar. And I want the world to know, Mike D and Landlord, that we matter, that our children matter.
This is Mike D.
And yours truly, Landlord. Get ready for Caribbean and Urban American Gospel Hits, Sundays here on Guardian Radio.
Caribbean and Urban American Gospel Hits, Sundays at 8 p.m., right here on Guardian Radio 96.9.
This is Guardian Radio 96.9 FM, Nassau, Bahamas.
This is the Guardian News Network update on the hour. Good afternoon, Bahamas. I'm Paige McCartney. Here's what's making news. With the two new FNM and PLP candidates ratified, campaigning for the West and Grand Bahama and Bimini by-election is expected to begin in earnest, despite outcry from some sects within the PLP that supported former Cabinet Minister Shane Gibson. Chief Passport Officer Kinsley Smith emerged victor at the PLP National General Council Friday night, vowing to live up to the expectations of being a fresh addition to a new PLP generation.
We must move forward. Be confident in yourself, what you can do, what you can achieve. Accomplish that one goal tonight is the first step. And the next step is now to get on the campaign trail and bring home the victory for the PLP.
The opposition's candidate, Bishop Ricardo Grant, was firing up a crowd of his supporters at his party's first by-election rally in Grand Bahama Saturday, cautioning constituents not to be bought and sold by the governing party.
They say this is a by-election. And if you spell it right, you'll know exactly what by we're talking about. Because I want to make it clear in this rally in the alley tonight that West Grand Bahama and Bimini is not for sale. I said we ain't for sale. We will not be bought. We will not sell out.
Parliamentary by-elections are rare, the last one taking place 11 years ago. Now the constituents and candidates must await the official filing of a writ of elections. Thereafter, the election must be held within 30 days. Meantime, tension ran high at the PLP General Council meeting following the election of its candidate, with some party members chanting their disapproval with party leader Prime Minister Philip Brave Davis for the choice. But in a message to party supporters this morning, PLP Chairman Fred Mitchell defended the party's decision to go with a fresh new political face with fresh new ideas.
We have no choice but to look to the future. We have no choice but to attract, invite, embrace a new generation.
In other news, following four traffic fatalities involving motorcycles in the past week alone, police say they're very concerned by the trend they're seeing. Chief Superintendent of Police David Lockhart had this word of caution to motorcyclists.
We can't emphasize to motorcycle riders to ensure that they have their cycles licensed, insured, inspected, and that they're wearing a helmet and that they are riding under the rules and regulations of the road.
The most recent fatality involving a motorcyclist occurred Sunday afternoon at around 4 p.m. in the Nassau Village area. The victim, a 24-year-old father of two, died at the scene. He was reportedly not wearing a helmet. And former Minister of Health and North Andros MP Dr. Perry Gomez, who's known for his contribution to the HIV and AIDS program in this country, has died. He passed away Saturday at the age of 76. Relatives told the Nassau Guardian he had been battling an ailment since May. Over the weekend, Prime Minister Philip Davis described Gomez as a giant in public health and a true son of Bahamian soil. Gomez is the founder and former director of the National HIV Program of the Bahamas. He also founded the AIDS Clinical Services Program at PMH. Under Dr. Gomez's leadership, HIV transmission rates in the Bahamas declined by more than 30%, while HIV transmission from mother to child has all but disappeared. And that's the news right now. You can read more on these stories in the Nassau Guardian. That's out on newsstands right now. Also online at thenassauguardian.com. Once again, I'm Paige McCartney. AP News is up next.
I'm Ed Donahue with an AP News Minute. Israeli airstrikes continue in Gaza while a small amount of aid is being moved into Gaza. Here's the AP's Karen Chamas.
The strikes persisted throughout Gaza, even in areas where the Israeli military told civilians to take refuge. Israel says it has stepped up airstrikes in order to reduce the risk to troops as they prepare for a ground offensive. A day earlier in central Gaza, civilians run for their lives as a building is pummeled to the ground by Israeli missiles. A woman's arm pokes out from under the rubble of the destroyed building. Residents scramble to remove the concrete that she is buried under. Over 4,000 people have been killed in Gaza since Israel's siege, according to the local health ministry. In Israel, over 1,000 people have been killed from a wide-scale Hamas attack, which prompted the Israeli military siege on Gaza. I'm Karen Chamas.
And I'm Ed Donahue.
This is Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM, Nassau, Bahamas.
And we are back, ladies and gentlemen, 96.9 FM Radio. Howard Grant and your company, the foundation on this absolutely beautiful October 23rd, Monday, here in the land of the living. Well, we in the land of the living, y'all got the liberty, and I'm in Hong Kong, locked up, doing my thing. I just got to be as decent as possible as we do this, guys. It's a beautiful day. I'm so grateful for the opportunity to kind of do this. And I'm grateful to be in good company. And one of the things that actually really, really excites me, my wife talks to me about it. She's like, boy, you love this thing. Hey, my God. I said, baby, don't. I don't know why, but I love this thing. When we start to talk about politics, when we start to break down the nuances, when we start to talk about the concept and idea of what we project, what we see happening, I love it. I love it. I'm not afraid to be wrong. But based upon the information I have, based upon the tradition that exists in this particular space, based upon the rhythm of how things have happened in yesteryear, I feel like I could give you at least sort of a good measure of what our expectations were, or could be, coming up in any one of those elections and things happening like that. Well, I'm joined by none other than my very good friend, Garth Roseboro, being able to do these things. Garth, I thank you so very kindly, my brother, for tuning in with us, for being here with us all the way from Nassau, having conversation with me all the way in Hong Kong. You are a good, decent man.
Yeah, so Howard, here's what I do not know. Here's what I do not know. I have a contact in Bimini that was previously an independent thinker. And since speaking with them, they told me this is going to be a PLP F&M thing. He said that the people of Bimini are very traditional in their voting. They believe that Bimini has been the gateway to the Bahamas and has been doing extremely well economically. And I'll say it on the air, that they feel that West Grand Bahama was more of a weight to them as opposed to an equal in terms of the economic growth. I've heard
that
some
would
very
be absolutely
nasty
unfair. That'll be absolutely unfair for them to say that.
But I know it is, but I'm once again being truthful here. The truth is painful, but the truth is that this is what is being said.
But there only could
the
be,
people of Bimini
that could only be a truth. Watch me. That could only be a truth from an unlearned mind. That can only be it cannot be the truth of what exists
well,
in a constituency in a space.
They're calling for their own candidate. They had only wished that they could have had their own constituency.
Randy Roll is there.
This is human.
Randy Roll is a whole Biminite, and he couldn't get a liquor vote. Okay? Bishop Ellis' brother, who the Free National Movement called last time. Huh? And they ain't calling back. I don't know why. Bishop Ellis had a plethora of brothers who can be able to go. The Ellis is right there from Poggy Bay. Could have been able to do a great deal of things. There are a great many a man and woman in West Grand, in Bimini, I'm sorry, that can be able to go forward. And that is why I say it to you that the imbalance of whatever allegation, prospect, idea that came to you that you just indicated is absolutely wrong. And it only could be from an unlearned mind. Because... Okay, let me give you an example. My grandfather's a Smith. His brother died in Uncle Don. This is my uncle, my granduncle, Uncle Don, died in the Chalks airline crash. You remember when the plane blew up into smokes? My grandfather's brother, younger brother, handsome, Uncle Don Smith, was on that plane. Okay? I'm trying to get some place with you. I have connections to Bimini. Now, it only takes me unearthing whatever the soot that exists on the top there for people to say, oh, yeah, boy, I know you. I know your ma. I know you this. For me to unearth that. But for a Biminite to have that same connection in West Grand Bahama, it doesn't work the same way. You might find your significant support in Bimini. And those people in Bimini know your ma, know you this, know you that. See, because Bimini historically has been a community unto itself. Bimini historically has been the community that never even accepted the outsiders and taken on these kind of positions. So things have changed and shifted over the years. So whoever told you that is consumed and only concerned with Bimini, but don't understand the layout of politics in this country. It has to go both ways. You have to have that experience and exposure. You have to have that relationship and that reach to reach people all the way from West End, all the way to the middle of 8 Mile Rock. And that is why Obadiah Wilgum did so well. If you really look deep down into Obi's relationships and his connection to every sub-community in West Grand Bahama and Bimini, this man have connections to the Turks Island community. He got connections to the Bimini community. He got connections to West End. He got connections to 8 Mile Rock. He got connections to Pinedale. You understand? This is why he is superb in that kind of a position. And also, coupled with the fact that he just came from ZNS, the whole country knew him. There could be no expectation that it'll work the next way around. So we have to be well-balanced in our approach of being able to look at the concept and idea of how politics is being laid out. Go ahead.
Well, I'll say that it's just human nature for people to have their own interest. When you look at Randy Roll, who's also an acquaintance of mine, Randy has always desired to be a representative in the House of Assembly. I do believe, and I can say this publicly, that being a former football sensation in college and then returning home, Randy Roll has done well by the Progressive Liberal Party because he's one of those young men who always seems to find a bone. And maybe it's the bone why he cannot enter the House of Assembly, because anytime he is qualified to become a threat to any nomination in the Progressive Liberal Party, they already know that all they need simply to do is throw him a bone. And so sooner or later, Randy Roll is going to have to decide if he really is for the people and not for himself, because any dog that gets a bone doesn't share. But if you really want to get some meat, to share amongst the Bimanites and the people of West Grand Bahama, you're going to have to now reject some bones and start making sure you get some meat. This is the time to show your strength, your tenacity, your resilience. But of course, he has been doing so well by just receiving bones. I doubt anytime soon that Bimini will have such a person as Randy Roll to represent them in House of Assembly. So rightly so, we see a Kingsley Smith being elevated to this position once again. He is, like you say, of relation. He is from the people. And as someone said from one of those independent groups, I was going and thinking of supporting you, but I can't go against my friend and family, Kingsley Smith.
I can touch this with
this
you.
Once again seems, as you said,
I can touch this.
This
with
is
you.
A family affair. You said it's a family affair.
I can touch
and
this.
That's what it's turning out to be.
I can touch this with you. I can touch this with you, and I can be very clear about some things. The way that you structured that conversation just now to talk about Randy Rule and his position to be able to get a bone. Randy's my guy. I like Randy. I like him. I think he has done. I think he's done well. I think his posture, his position, his strategic. He has identified how to be able to kind of shimmy up to the right people, the right category, the right position, the right environments to see himself elevate.
Yes.
He's done well. He's done very well, and I want to be able to commend him. Right, and his pursuit of a bone. This proverbial bone that you talk about. I believe that it's finding meat with every progressive step and his strategic position. If he looks for that meat, he needs to stay put. Can I say that? If he's looking for meat on that bone, he needs to stay put. Continue to be able to work with the revitalization of downtown. Continue to be able to work. I see him in Atlanta the other day and being able to do a great deal of things. He have great relationships to make those things happen. Continue to work in those areas and then find yourself in due time and due season with the kind of contract that can change your life, the kind of relationship that can change your life, right? I think that that's what many of us are looking for. But if we're going to be honest, Kimsley, I mean, he is my cousin, but you know, when you put yourself, you put your name in a public hat, you know, it's no holds barred. Everything I believe is sort of up for grabs when we have this kind of a conversation. And decency and order, of course. You cannot start to talk about this proverbial bone having and bone getting and collection without being able to put his name in the mix. Kimsley Smith, who has just been given an opportunity with the passport office, has taken that opportunity. And listen to me, let's just go back some. Kimsley came back from school. He pursued a position in the Free National Movement. Oh my God, that's how these get too deep, too quick, too fast. Let's just be decent. He pursued a position in the Free National Movement. And in pursuing a position in the Free National Movement, he did everything that he could be able to do to find himself in a position in the Free National Movement. He wasn't successful. He went off to school, fortified himself, and was viewed as a threat in some instances. Came back to the Free National Movement. The thing didn't work out the way that he wanted it to work out. Detached himself from the organization because he recognized that the organization was not prepared. The PLP, which is an organization that identifies youth talent and is willing to give a chance, especially to, you know, a young progressive person that is growing and learning and eager to kind of put himself in the position, he attached himself to the PLP. So much so, he ascended rather quickly, I managed to tell you that, to a position in West Grand Bahama to be identified as a possible candidate. Those candidates in the last general election would have been Obadiah Wilscombe, who was being snuffed, who was being given the cold shoulder by this administration. He was initially being given the cold shoulder. Obi got deep into the pocket of his relationship and the necessity of being able to uphold the standards of democracy. That's what got him this position. So it was Obi, Kimsley, and Ginger. I'm sure it was, I think, Kirk Cornish also. Not Kirk Cornish. Oh, Jesus. Not Kirk Cornish. Oh, my God. One other person, right? So the fact of the matter is that Kimsley ascended significantly, did not succeed. He was the only person who didn't succeed in that. Ginger was able to move from her aspirations from West Grand Bahama. She's a West Grand Bahamian young lady. She born and grew down there. She moved from that position, and now she's a representative as the Minister of Grand Bahama and the Member of Parliament from Pine Ridge. I'm simply saying to you that when it comes to this bone getting, I think young aspirants are all in pursuit of that proverbial bone. You cannot have this conversation without saying that Kimsley Smith was not after a bone himself. And in fact, if in all decency, The question is whether or not Bishop Ricardo Grant is also after this proverbial bone. This bone is a bone of sustainability. This bone is a bone of establishment. This bone is a proverbial bone of social recognition and being able to ascend. That when people see you synonymously, you're synonymous with success and growth and development. That's what this bone is about. Everyone in these positions are pursuing this bone because it exists within the realm of politics. It exists within this particular space. So you can't say one game after the bone, if the next one ain't going. The only person who would have been established and would have already been able to chew and lick all over this proverbial bone would have been Shane Gibson. He was the only person. And so this race in West Grand Bahama is going to be extremely interesting. Talk to me about it.
Well, I like, and I'll give some kudos here, just to be fair. I like the ease of the Free National Movement to select a candidate in this particular situation.
I feel like that's a whole different show.
I know we had spoken on the show, the foundation, last week about a recommendation that came to the leader as to whether to participate in this by-election or not. But we do see the participation taking place. We see that the candidate selection seemed to us to be somewhat seamless. We are now looking to see what is the strengthening factors that will go ahead and support this particular candidate, and how well would the candidate in the form of your cousin, your family, be able to fight against a governmental Progressive Liberal Party in this by-election. So far, if PLPs are somewhat disgruntled, I do not believe that that is a large faction of PLPs that are that disgruntled. I do believe that, I don't know, maybe through some coercion, through some, I guess, sharing and caring, that the Progressive Liberal Party may once again unite. But definitely the FNM may now have an opportunity to enter into this fight at this particular time.
When the Free National Movement placed Ricardo Grant in that position and the Progressive Liberal Party decided not to run Shane Gibson, the traditional concept of how we know politics and the idea of financial and political clout and influence being able to take over, almost hidden pilot, you know what I mean? Like cruise control at one point. Everything is off the table now. None of that exists. Everyone, every man for himself and God for us all. Let me take this quick commercial break, ladies and gentlemen, and be right back after this.
It's Whopper Wednesday every Wednesday at Burger King Nassau. Make your Wednesday sizzle and sink your teeth into a flame-grilled beef patty topped with tomatoes, fresh-cut lettuce, mayo, pickles, ketchup, and sliced onions, all on a toasted sesame seed bun with fries for only $5.95. Including VAT. This Whopper Wednesday, grab a friend and head down to your favorite BK Nassau location for a flame-grilled Whopper made your way with crisp fries for only $5.95. Burger King Nassau, where taste is King.
At Ron's Electric Motors, they repair and rewind all major brands of electric motors, including water pumps, generators, and the generator's back end, welding machines, electric lifts, air compressors, battery chargers, and more. They're equipped to handle up to 850 kilowatts and rewind up to 450 horsepower motors. They're conveniently located on the corner of Wolf and Clarence Roads and are open weekdays 8 a.m. to 5 p.m., Saturdays till noon. They offer 24 hours emergency assistance. You can reach them at 242-356-0249.
Too many debt bills? Overdue on loan payments? Improve your credit score and credit report with the Bahamas Credit Bureau. Shrink your debt payments with a debt consolidation loan and built-in savings that pays you 5% interest. Call 356-7764.
Tired of banks forcing you to use technology to bank the way they want you to? Your convenience is important. So no matter what your banking needs, Commonwealth Bank's friendly staff are always available in branch for that personal one-on-one service. But when you choose technology, our online and mobile banking app offers you state-of-the-art functionality. The choice is yours. Commonwealth Bank. Bank the way you want.
And we are back, ladies and gentlemen, 96.9 FM Radio. Howard Grant and your company, The Foundation. Day 4, locked up. All the way in Hong Kong. Doing our thing. Next time you hear me, I should be in the studio. Hopefully. It's a long flight, but we're going to be able to do some things. I want to be able to give a shout out to all those persons who are assisting me to kind of get up off these people's floor and bench and whatnot. I had to take a bath, man, a cold shower. I buy some cologne because I didn't wash my clothes. I can't take this. My God, I don't live like this. I'm a decent man. Praise God. I'm not going to fight it. Ladies and gentlemen, we're talking politics today. I'm hoping that you're enjoying the conversation. I'm hoping that you enjoy the participation. I won't be able to take the gloves off, though. I'm sitting here talking with none other than my very good friend, Garth Roseborough. Garth, I'm always excited to talk to you, but I won't take the gloves off. I won't take the gloves off. If you give me a chance, my brother, let me yuck the gloves off and be able to bare knuckles and talk about what we got to talk about, because it's no holds barred. At this point, there's no game. At this point, like I said, every man for himself and God for us all. Now, toe to toe, pound for pound, flesh for flesh, politically, Kimsley Smith could never touch Ricardo Grant. He can't. He ain't ready for that kind of action. Ricardo Grant has been a pastor, a bishop, an apostle in West Grand Bahama and Bimini, all throughout the length and breadth of the country. You know him. If you're in the church circle, you know him. He has been dynamite in his youthful days, creating this universal household of faith over the course of time and being able to do a great deal of things. You cannot touch this man. He understands posture. He understands people. He understands articulation. He's a learned man. He's a man of the cloth. He has significant relationships within the church community, within certain societies. Talk to me. Let's just be very clear about this. You cannot touch this man. Not pound for pound. Your political organization is going to have to go into overdrive to beat him. It's going to have to. Kimsley has always been very soft-spoken, not necessarily timid, always determined to kind of move forward with these particular things. That in contrast to a position that Ricardo Grant's dynamic posture, position, his overtone, his articulation, sometimes it comes off a little condescending because of the elevated position of being able to preach to you. I think that may be his downfall, that kind of a preaching to you, but not necessarily speaking to you or speaking with you. His elevation has always been behind the pulpit, but not necessarily with the people. Can I say that? I know this man personally. Y'all need to stop. Don't ask me no questions. I'm telling you what it is. My predictions for the general for the by-elections, my predictions, this is Howard Grant. First time I rule it out, these are the dice. After everybody's been ratified, identified, let's throw it on the table. Bam. Ricardo Grant is going to win this by at least 1,000 votes. Minimum. He's going to win the by-election by 1,000 votes. Because at the end of the day, it comes down to your ability to convince people. I don't want to use persuade because the man is a man of God. Let's be decent. Your ability to convince people of your posture, your position, your articulation, your strength, your capability. See, the people of West Grand Bahama have already shown you that we're not stupid enough to just take your money and put a foreigner into the space and place. When I say foreigner, not foreign to the Bahamas, not foreign to politics, but foreign to the rhythm of the community. We're not stupid enough just to take your money, take your word, your promises, and put someone historically that we have never even looked at, especially Bimini people. Historically, they have never looked at a quote-unquote proverbial, not actual, now let's be decent about this, an outsider, outside of the realms of the development in a specific community. Both Ricardo Grant and Kimsley Smith born and grow in West Grand Bahama and Bimini. You know that. They born and grow there. They live there. They are family. We are family. And the community recognizes that. You hear some people yelling and screaming about Shane Gibson, but you hear the stories about who these persons were, and you'd recognize that these are the people who were always, you know, looking for something. Let's just be decent. I knew you want to be decent. Let's be very decent. Let's be clear and clean about this in this approach. Now, I want to talk like this and make you to understand something. Pound for pound, Kimzie Smith can't take Ricardo Grant. It's going to have to be turned up by 1,000 for Kimzie Smith. If he wins, it's going to be by maybe 150 votes. And that can only be because the F&M machinery doesn't identify and pull those persons out in the various polling divisions. There is more F&M strong polling. Okay, so we've already identified that there is turmoil that exists within the PLP. We have already identified that. Let's just talk the numbers now. We have already identified that there's turmoil that exists within the PLP. And in identifying that, that means that polling divisions that exist in Bimini and in West End proper already is tumultuous. Now it takes persuasion. Now it takes those generals to come in there to have those conversations. Now it's time to take those particular persons to come in there and say, hey, listen, I know that you're indifferent about this. Kimzie Smith is a good fellow. He's straight, man. Don't worry about him. The PLP can give him an opportunity. He got to strengthen himself in these areas. You got to give Ricardo Grant an opportunity. I believe that Ricardo Grant is going to take this. Not no for no F&M or nothing. Ricardo Grant, the individual, is going to take this. Now, I do believe that he will not win in 2026. Oh, my God. I do believe, let's shoot straight. He can take it for now. His probationary period will be for 720-something days, and the people will not give him an opportunity in 2026. I'll just be very clear with you. This is what I just do.
Listen, Howard. I love history because history doesn't lie. In 2010 and 11, when we, you know, Malcolm Adderley made that decision to go ahead and resign from the House of Assembly for the Elizabeth constituency, the Progressive Liberal Party was in opposition. They controlled the Elizabeth seat as the royal opposition. The Free National Movement had the entire treasury, the purse of the oligarchs, and of course, at that particular time, it was a battle. It was a brutal battle. But let us remember that the Progressive Liberal Party prevailed. They retained, I use the word retained, the seat, even in the face of a government treasury. Now, the Progressive Liberal Party is now the government, but it is also their seat, vacated by one of their beloved representatives. I anticipate that knowing that nothing will happen in terms of a benefit for the people of West Grandma and Bimini to change the Free National Movement, I don't think that seat is going to change. There's nothing to be gained from it other than if the Free National Movement were to prevail and win that seat, or any other party, anyone that prevails, that would be a momentum shift towards a general election. Now, with the inner turmoil of the Free National Movement, here is now the litmus test. Here is now that which is going to tell us, can the Free National Movement mobilize, unite? Are they willing to mobilize, unite, move forward one step at a time towards 2026? Or are they simply going to continue to be confused between a previous prime minister and the present leader of the party?
See, I like what you're saying.
What I'm seeing now is
I like what you're saying.
Less confusion in the Free National Movement now, no. Which is a very good token to me that it's possible that the Free National Movement is now maturing under new leadership and preparing for 2026 in so much that look at how quickly, fluidly, and easily they were able to get the candidate and move behind the candidate.
Okay, so let's just shoot straight and tell you what it is.
Go ahead.
Ricardo Grant has been working the ground over 6 months whilst Obadiah Wilchcombe was in the seat. Ricardo Grant was already touching people on the ground for maybe almost a year. He was travailing the constituency for almost a year. He had already long time time, discuss with persons about the prospect of him becoming the next candidate for West Grand Bahama and Bimini. So this was done. This was done. He had already received commitment and he was working simultaneously with the assurance of that commitment that he would be the candidate next go round. Obi, alive and well. You hear me? Obi, alive and well in the land of the living. Ricardo Grant had committed himself to working the ground in West Grand Bahama and Bimini. All those persons who had any potential desires of representation, he identified those persons, befriended them, and pulled them into his fold. I told you this man is, he know what he doing. He's sharp. Everyone who should have had aspirations to say something from a Free National Movement standpoint did nothing because they had already pledged their allegiance to Ricardo Grant's campaign. When the Free National Movement's caucus, their headquarters in Nassau, would have heard about it, some MZMs called me and say, well, Jesus, how would I didn't even know that Bishop Grant was raking the ground a long time. I knew. If you go back a couple months, I said to you, my good cousin Ricardo Grant said he wouldn't be the thing for the next go-round. He has two churches, one Universal Household of Faith in Hawksbill and the other one Community Holiness at the edge of, in the middle of 8 Mile Rock. And I was indifferent with him leaving the church to be able to do that, but that's not my business. I'm simply saying to you that he was hard at work already, hard at work, being able to get that. So when you saw him seamlessly step into this position without opposition, it was not because there weren't aspirations or desire. It was because he had already pledged allegiance and pronounced himself in that position. That's one. Secondly, when you identify these things and you look at the numbers and look at the layout, there is a mindset that exists in West Grand Bahama and Bimini just because of what you said, that because of the government of the day who retained this seat, and because the party that retained this seat or had this seat, that they are now in government, there is an expectation historically that they will retain this seat. But if you look at this and look at the dynamics that are playing out here, Kimsley Smith can never fill the shoes of Obadiah Hercules Bushkin. Now, there's no expectation that he would. But West Grand Bahamian people, especially those PLP sycophants who are out there screaming in the streets, understand dynamics. The only thing that could revive, restore, rejuvenate West Grand Bahama is proximity to leadership. The only thing that could cause infrastructural development is proximity to leadership. Not a backbencher, rookie, novice MP, politician, but someone who could be able to, because of his seniority politically, could step right into the cabinet and make things happen, is why a lot of persons agitated and advocated for Shane Gibson. Let's be very clear about this. If West Grand Bahamian people understand that, for me, even if Kimsley Smith wins, Kimsley Smith again will not win. And whoever wins this by-election, I don't believe that this is a determination of the general election. Whoever wins this by-election, in my humble opinion, personal view, will not win their seat in 2026. They cannot. I just want to shoot straight with that and be a couple and be as decent as possible when we're putting things on the table. Guys, we're here, we're having conversation, we're chopping these things down. We're getting toe-to-toe and talking about from traditional politics for the prospects of new generational politics and the mindset that exists again and our expectations of what we could see leading into the future. Let me take this quick commercial break, guys, and be right back after this.
The Grand Bahama News is available every Tuesday in the Nassau Guardian. Buy your local paper at Freeport convenience stores, Western Bakery, DeGregory's Fine Foods, and Bellevue Gifts. Want to reach your Grand Bahama customers? Then call Barefoot Marketing at 827-4578 or message them for ad rates via their Facebook page. Advertising opportunities now include classified ads too. Keep up with all the latest Grand Bahama news in the Nassau Guardian newspaper every Tuesday.
Always on the go? Missed the show? You can now listen to Guardian Radio talk shows anytime, anywhere on Spotify and YouTube by searching Guardian Radio 96.9 FM or by entering the name of your favorite show. You can also listen by logging on to guardiantalkradio.com and clicking on the podcast tab. Guardian Radio, continuing to provide you with fresh news and smart talk anywhere, anytime, all day.
We've been with you from the very start, leading the way and providing you with the best in primetime sporting experiences. From one goal to the next, you can count on us for full access to the best sports channels at home or on the go. Make Rev your only choice. Visit Rev.bs. Every match, every game, every moment. Rev, your home for sports.
America completely run out of it.
You've tried everything. ASUS with your mother's cousin's sister's auntie, and even hiding your money under your mattress. But is your money safe? Your Bahamian dollar deposit in a member bank or credit union is insured up to $50,000. If anything happens, your deposit up to the insured value will be returned to you thanks to Deposit Insurance. Visit Deposit Insurance Corporation at www.dic.bs.
Protection for your money guaranteed with DIC.
It's Whopper Wednesday every Wednesday at Burger King Nassau. Make your Wednesday sizzle and sink your teeth into a flame-grilled beef patty topped with tomatoes, fresh-cut lettuce, mayo, pickles, ketchup, and sliced onions, all on a toasted sesame seed bun with fries for only $5.95, including VAT. This Whopper Wednesday, grab a friend and head down to your favorite BK Nassau location for a flame-grilled Whopper made your way with crisp fries for only $5.95. Burger King Nassau, where taste is king.
Love the show? Want to give your support? Become a sponsor today. Call 302-2300 for our rates and packages. That's 302-2300. Become a sponsor on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
And we are back, ladies and gentlemen, 96.9 FM Radio. Howard Grant and your company, The Foundation. All the way from Hong Kong, we are locked up in Hong Kong, just waiting to kind of get out of here and do our thing. Ladies and gentlemen, we are excited to do that. I'm on this last segment today, just being able to talk about it. I'm here with my very good friend, Garth Roseboro, just talking politics, just talking what we see on the ground. When we left off, Garth, I started to talk about, it doesn't matter who wins. I don't believe Howard Grant, for the new dispensation of politics, with the history of what existed yesteryear, and the idea of how things are changing and ever moving, and how this is a fluid situation to make a determination of what's going to happen in our country in the future, I don't believe that either Bishop Ricardo Grant or Kimsley Smith, I don't believe that their success will dictate the success of their political organization. I do not believe it. Let me tell you why. I believe that this is a very personal situation. This is a very personal issue. And because of the sort of the fragile nature that exists in West Grand Bahama with the loss of Obadiah Wolfscombe, persons are looking for someone that they could be able to talk to, that they believe can fill this particular shoe, that has the articulation, the strength, that has good proximity to leadership, so forth and so on, that gives you this prospect that they can get something done. That's why I say there may be this concept that Ricardo Grant may take the entire thing. But even if he does that, I do not see him winning the thing in 2026. I just won't put it like that. Both of them have a probationary period to show their strength. And if I'm going to be straight with you.
You know, Howard, I'm listening to you. You use some adjectives and some adverbs, and you know, I'm listening to your language. But I'm hearing that the politicians of today, those who are aspiring, I sense that you have a fear of their weakness. You caused me to ask the question, and I actually began to despair just a while ago. I got really, really sad just a while ago listening to you. Not that you're not hitting the nail on the head. You have not proven your accuracy so far. I don't know if the end result is going to be the same. But what I have determined in my mind that makes me very sad, Howard Grant, is that the politicians of today seem so much more weaker than the politicians of yesterday. The politicians of today seem so much more greedy than the politicians of yesteryear. And it almost seems to me that the direction the country is going in is not a very good compass.
There's no politicians.
Instead of heading north,
there's no politicians in this race. There's no politicians in this race. There's a preacher and an aspirant who aspires to move towards politics.
Himself. I understand the conversation of first-time politician, first-time aspirant, first-time member of parliament. And I know that it's a growth process. We've seen the Renwood Wells come from the NDP party, move into the PLP party, and rise in the FNM party. We've seen these things. We've watched these men begin to mature, and for some of them, they've lost their way as they matured. But to now look at what we're now viewing as our future, the confidence necessary in such people, are we simply just settling for one side or the other? Are we truly looking for leaders? Are we truly looking for people who can change our country for better?
We talked about
what in the dickens has happened to the Bahamian people and this whole idea of moving forward, upward, and onward together. What is going on?
Now let's.
When did the national fish become grouper, and when did the national flower become hibiscus?
This tuna.
You know, when did the national bird become chicken?
Let's do this.
How the heck have we gotten this wrong?
I can tell you this: political organizations of the past. Let's just hit the history. Political organizations of the past could not deny the talent because we came from a sleeping village. We came from a time where Grimy Dem used to tell you things like, well, women are to be seen and not heard. Baby, keep your mouth, little children are to be seen and not heard. Everyone knew their sector and subsector, right? And that's why we could even start to talk about and boast of this idea of, and I can take it here just for 2 seconds and pull it right back. We could even have this sort of a boast of an idea that this is a sweetheart society, because in yesteryear, when your grandmother saw your grandfather or great-grandfather doing some things, they just adhere to it. They say, well, you know, you're doing this, you know, I saw this and I know that, and they never pushed back at it. All right? So the passive approach or the passivity that exists in our society always allowed for you to identify emerging voices. And as a result of those emerging voices that always pop like a blackhead to the top of the conversation, it's like the ivory soap. They always came to the front. Political organizations had a very easy task. They could see talent, identify talent, and pull it in. The PLP was excellent at that. I must say the PLP is still excellent at that, right? The FNM was also good at it. Not as good, but the FNM was also good at it. They strengthened themselves after Ingram came in. Now, let's be very clear about this. Because of the modern era that we're in, because of the proximity of a conditioning of the United States of America and this kind of a capitalist mindset, all for me, baby, has been able to seep and steep into the DNA of a great deal of Bahamian aspirants politically. Their articulation could sway you, but their fruits is what you have to tell them by. Political organizations chose for us. That should be very clear. The people of West Grand Bahama and Bimini did not choose a candidate, whether that be Ricardo Grant or whether that be Kimsley Smith. Political organizations chose this candidate, both of them. When persons are voting in the next general election, they are voting based upon what the political organization has placed to the forefront. And as a result of that, if you have sway, if you have articulation, poise, and posture, your ability to give some frequency and rhythm to your words, it's possible that you could find yourself in the House of Assembly. But for the truth is, the aspirant, the young politician, if they don't have gusto, if they don't have gonads, if they don't have that wherewithal, that determination, if they don't have a call on their life, an anointing, if you please, talk to me, to be able to fulfill a purpose that is bigger than them and touch the people of their constituency for reformation, growth, and development in this country, you're going to see much of the exact same thing. So don't dismay. Don't dismay. Don't dismay. Don't feel downtrodden. Because what you're seeing is a silhouette of men, but not necessarily the substance of reform in this country. Let's just be very clear about this. Okay? It is time for us, and this is why conversations like this happening in real time. It is time for us to identify and push past the curtain to talk about the inconsistencies that exist in this space and what needs to happen for growth and development. It is time for us to look at the frail nature of these political organizations that no longer run after the purposes of growth and development in our constituencies, but being able to consistently fortify their agenda. It's time for us to push past that. Now, I'm going to go back at this again. Whoever wins this on probation, because the politics of our community is changing. People ain't into it no more. We've gone through the rhythm of FNM PLP. And it is time for us to make a determination to make some things happen. I'm going to let you take the last word before we get out of here. Go ahead.
You feel it's time for...
I can let you take the last word. They say it's time for us to make a determination to be able to move in a particular direction.
I didn't catch the last of your sentence.
No, I say it's time for us to make a determination of who is right mm-hmm. for the people. The people have to make that determination. Political organizations can't do it. Take this piece out.
You know, Howard, I was at a function last night, and you know, I just want to tell Miss Annette Lloyd, you know, happy birthday again, wonderful lady. I was at a function, and there were a number of politicians there, you know. Great event. And I just want to say something here. When are we going to mature as a people and force even your beloved party, let's say your PLP, let's say your FNM, whether you're a third-party member, when are we going to get to the maturity that forces the organization to give you the best candidate possible? Not someone in your Lord Society, not someone in your church, not someone who is a family member, but someone who can actually get the job done. When does the constituency say, you know what, we want the best? Or are we too busy attempting to survive that we don't have time to really look at what is best for us in terms of the House of Assembly? We're too busy hustling. Where are we going in all of this, man? Total confusion. We've not gone anywhere. Holes in the road, road paved. Holes in the road, road paved. Holes in the road, road paved. Where are we going? Where are the superhighways? Where is the innovation that they spoke about some 10, 15, 20 years ago? Where's the ingenuity? Where are the people of wisdom who can learn from places like China as to how to advance a nation? Where are the people who can go to Rwanda and find out how does Rwanda go from ruins into one of the greatest now nations of the world? Why do we even have ambassadors to this country? What the heck are they doing for foreign affairs if they can't go to foreign lands and bring us the wisdom and bring us the resources that are necessary to move our country forward?
My brother,
I'm so sick and tired of us just having a form of governance,
yeah,
but denying the power thereof.
My God, you just get preachy quickly. I love it. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to thank you so much for tuning in with us today. That's The Foundation, all the way from Hong Kong. Locked up, doing our thing. I am with none other than my good, decent friend, Garth Roseborough. You're going to hear more and more from us. Next week, I've committed to kind of going down there if my wife will be so kind as to let me go. Praise God. Let me go. Let us give us free, right? That's good. Let me see if I can do that. We're having great conversations, guys. I want to thank you so very kindly as we dive deeper in preparation for this by-election that's going to be happening in the country. I thank you so very kindly, guys. If you want to be a part of the conversation, want to be able to sponsor us, you want to be able to assist us in being able to get over there. We want your help. 827-0111. Garth, my brother, I thank you so much for always being able to wear your heart on your sleeve and be as transparent as possible about what you'd like to see in this country going forward. You're a good, decent man. My ladies and gentlemen, I want to see you here tomorrow. Let's see if we can be able to grab a minister or someone to have a good conversation with us to kind of chop this down on what our expectations are in the next general, next by-election here in the country. Have a beautiful day. Guys, stick and stay for Chivago with Z Live right after this.
The foundation. Foundation.